A few months ago, I posted a video pertaining to how one can distinguish between Airbus and Boeing airplanes, and on that video I outlined two simple ways of telling an Airbus from a Boeing airplane. The first way, which is by observing the shape of the nose, whereby I said some Airbus planes like the Airbus A320 and the Airbus A380 have a round and a plump nose, while all Boeing airplanes have a pointy nose. The second way outlined on that video was by looking at the shape of the outermost cockpit side windows, whereby I said most Airbus planes have cockpit side windows which are almost square shaped, while all Boeing airplanes have V-shaped cockpit side windows. If you wish to check out that video, kindly do so through the card on the top right of the video. Now recently, a good friend of mine asked me a very interesting question. How then can one be able to identify the specific Airbus and Boeing airplane families together with their variants? And I think this is a very good question which deserves its own video, since all the videos I've come across on YouTube only give ways of distinguishing Airbus and Boeing airplanes in general and not their specific models, which is why I decided to make a video about this topic to tackle this problem once and for all. So, how can you identify the specific Airbus and Boeing airplane families together with their variants? Let's find out. Since this is a very detailed topic, I decided to cover it in two videos. The first video, which is this one, will deal with the narrow-body airplanes, while the second video, which will be out next week, will deal with the wide-body airplanes. Narrow-body airplanes, as with their name, are those planes with a single aisle through the passenger cabin, which separates the seating into two groups. The Airbus A320, the Boeing 737 and the Boeing 757 are classic examples of narrow-body airplanes. Wide-body airplanes, on the other hand, are those airplanes with two aisles, which divide the seating into three groups. The Airbus A350, the Boeing 777 and the Boeing 787 are classic examples of wide-body airplanes. First, let's understand what airplane families are. Airplane families are comprised of airplanes with relatively similar features. For example, the Airbus A320 is an airplane family. In between the family, we have the specific variants, which for our case with the A320 family is made up of the Airbus A318, Airbus A319, A320 and the A321 variants. The main difference between airplane variants is the length. As you can notice, the Airbus A321 is much longer than the Airbus A320 and the A320 is longer than the Airbus A319 and so on. The main reason as to why the variants differ in length is to allow more passenger seats to be put on the longer models. As a side note, the Airbus A320 family is grouped into two. The first group being the Airbus A320ceo, standing for current engine option, and the second group being the Airbus A320neo, standing for new engine option. By their names, the A320ceo family is made up of the variants with the older generation engines, while the neo family is made up of the models with the newer, more efficient turbofan engines. In order to distinguish between an A320ceo from an A320neo, just look at the engines. The neo model has larger engines than the ceo model. The Airbus A320 family is the only narrow-body airplane in the Airbus lineup. Now, let's move on to the Boeing lineup. The Boeing narrow-body lineup is made up of the Boeing 707, 727, 737 and the Boeing 757. For simplicity, I'll tackle the Boeing 737 and the Boeing 757, since the two are more common at airports around the world today than their latter. Let's begin with the Boeing 757, and before we even explore its variants, let's understand how you can identify a Boeing 757. Also nicknamed the flying pencil, the Boeing 757 can easily be recognized instantly by observing its landing gears, which are very tall, and also the plane can be identified through observing its fuselage, which is long and very skinny. The third and the final way of telling a 757 is by observing the number of wheels on each main landing gear. You can easily see that each landing gear has four wheels. The Boeing 757 is the only narrow-body airplane apart from the Boeing 707 which has four wheels on each of its main landing gears. All other narrow-body airplanes have two wheels on their main landing gears, making the 757 a unique narrow-body airplane. The 757 has two variants, which are the -200 and the longer -300 variants. The -200 is 47 meters long, while the -300 is 54 meters long. The -300 variant is actually the longest Boeing narrow-body airplane in the world. Just like with the Airbus A320 family, the length is the only distinguishing feature between the 757 variants. The final narrowbody for this video is the Boeing 737, and before you explore the family and its variants, let's find out how you can identify a Boeing 737. The 737 is one of the easiest narrowbody airplanes to identify, mainly because of its popularity. It can easily be identified by observing the shape of its engines, which have a flat bottom, mainly because of the low design of the Boeing 737. The plane can also be recognized by observing its main landing gear wheel wells, which have no doors. The 737 family is classified into four groups: the older generation models, the classic models, the next generation models, and finally, the Max models. The older generation models are made up of the -100 and the longer -200 variants. These planes can easily be identified by observing their engines, which are very long and run through the underwing. Next, we move on to the classics models. The classics models are made up of the -300, -400, -500 and the -600 variants. These variants can be identified by their engines, which are larger than those of the older generation models. However, unlike other airplane variants, length cannot be a distinguishing feature for the 737 Classics. The -400 is the longest, being 36 meters long, and it is followed by the -300, which is 33 meters long. The -500 and 600 variants are each 31 meters long. Next, we move on to the next generation, or the NG models. These variants can easily be identified by observing the winglets on their wings. The NG models of the 737 are made up of the -700, -800 and the -900 variants, with the -900 being the longest and the -700 being the shortest. And last but not the least are the Max models. The Max models are the latest iteration of the 737 family, and they are comprised of the Max 7, the Max 8, the Max 9 and the longest one being the Max 10. To identify the Max, just look at its engines, which are large and have chevrons on their exhaust. And that's it with the narrowbody airplanes of the Airbus and the Boeing lineup, and I hope now you can be able to identify the families and the variants of each plane. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more great aviation content coming soon. The second video will be out next week, and until I see you again, stay safe and take care. Goodbye.